아유, 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 아유.
Number one, and also part of all forces team. Dan maintained his standard of excellence as far as being a volunteer out here and rendering honors to America's heroes. Our heroes are our veterans, period. Dan really set the bar for all of us. He embraced the core values that every Marine on active duty or a veteran. Honor, courage, and commitment every day of his life. He was definitely a model to aspire to. All of the volunteers here are no longer on active duty or in the reserves. We date back to the Korean War, Vietnam War, Iraq, Afghanistan, and a few skirmishes in between. But when we come in that gate, on the dates that we render honors here, our sole purpose is to honor those who have fallen before us. That's our paycheck. That's what we get out of it. We have a bagpiper, bugler, rifle team. It does echo in here a little bit for those with hearing aids or have little ones. You may have to block their ears. When the bugler plays taps, I'd like all to rise. Veterans render a proper hand salute, all others hand across the heart. And with that, we'll get started. Bugler! Sound! Attention!
Detail, on, kid, hunt! Back, east! Four, march! Fire! Hey, fire! Hey, fire! Freeze it! Fire!
Detail, hold, ready, face.
President of the United States, the Armed Forces of the United States, the United States Marine Corps, the Commandant of the Marine Corps, and all Marines around the globe. Please accept this flag as a token and honorable and faithful service to his country.
California Legislature Assembly, Certificate of Recognition, presented to Dan Dyer in honor of his memory and service to our country. It is my privilege to present this certificate to recognize his lifetime of achievements and patriotism. He will be greatly missed by those whose lives he's touched. His work and legacy will live forever in the hearts of his family, friends, and colleagues. Signed, Jose Medina, Assembly Member, 61st Assembly District.
House of Representatives, Certificate of Congressional Recognition in honor of Dan Dyer. In recognition of your dedicated military service to your country, signed Mark Takano, Member of Congress, House of Representatives, dated May 29, 2013.
Has fallen, a United States Marine. There is a poem we read in their honor. The author and the date are unknown. Till the last landings are made, and we stand unafraid on a shore which no mortal has seen,
to the last bugle call, plays taps for us all. Semper Fidelis Marine.
Ladies and gentlemen, this concludes the military honors portion of the service. And again, friends and family of Dan Dyer are indeed with us. Retrieve the colors. Face. Forward. March.
Scripture to you that I want to read one more time. It's out of the book of John, the 11th chapter, the 25th verse. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life, and he who believes in me will live, even though he dies, and whoever lives and believes in me will never die. Then he asked, do you believe this? Daniel Dyer did. You know that. You knew him. And he let everybody else know too, who he served. His country and his King, the Lord Jesus Christ. As it's the Christian's belief in Christ and the resurrection and the life, the strong validation by Christ's own resurrection from the grave and death that encourages our hearts as we face the departure of a loved one. We can plan for the future with hope. Daniel had that hope. Daniel had that plan for the future. I'm amazed at how many among us plan for certain events in the future. We plan to go to school. We plan to graduate. We plan to get a job. We plan to go on vacation. We plan to get married. We plan to have children. And yet so many plan to fail to plan for the future. And I'm talking about beyond retirement. Dan was prepared for that future. And if you have not, I would encourage you again today, as I know that Dan would do, to be prepared for that future. We read in the book of Romans, what then shall we say in response to this? If God is for us, who can be against us? He who did not spare his own son, but gave him up for us all, how will he also, along with him, generously give us all things? Who will bring any charge against those whom God has chosen? It is God who justifies. Who is he that condemns? Christ Jesus, who died, more than that, was raised from the life, is at the right hand of God, also interceding for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall trouble, or hardship, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or sword? As it is written, for your sake we face death all day long, and are considered as sheep for the slaughter. Knowing all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. And I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor demons, neither the present, nor the future, nor any power, neither the height, nor the depth, nor anything else in all of creation will be able to separate us from the love of God that is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Today, Dan Dyer is in the presence of that love, the Lord Jesus Christ. I wish I knew exactly what it was like. I know so many people ask, and especially as a pastor, I'm asking all the time, what is heaven like? And there's been numerous books written on it. We've had several of the writers of the scripture try and tell us. Ezekiel gives us some hints in chapter 1 and 10 of his book. Daniel chapter 6 speaks of the same thing. I think Paul the Apostle had it right when he said, you know, I can't even find the words to say what it's really like. Some of the things that we read just add to our wonder. I want to read you what the Apostle John wrote in the book of Revelation. He says in chapter 21, I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. Dan was his people. Many of us here today are his people. If you're not, you are offered the opportunity to become a part of the family of God. And God himself will be with them, and he will be their God. And here's the future. God will wipe away every tear from their eyes. There'll be no more death, no more sorrow, no more crying, no more pain, for the former things are passed away. It makes me wonder sometimes why we cling so tightly to the things of this earth. What is it that we like so much? Is it the smog? The traffic? The taxes? Wondering who the next leader is going to be. It was mentioned earlier that people value gold in this world, but that's just the asphalt of heaven. God has prepared so much for us. I like to think of the new body. Dan's got his new body. I told you I'm a little jealous. I want that body. Those of you that are a little bit older know that this one starts falling apart. It doesn't do what it used to do. It can't run as far, or jump as high, or stay awake as long. But we see Christ for a few brief passages in his new body. He was able to appear and to disappear. Wouldn't that be fun? Show up in the middle of a crowd like he did with the disciples. And we know, I used to think of people walking in heaven with the Lord, but we know that when Jesus left this earth, he ascended. He was able to fly. You know Dan loved flying. I bet he's flying around heaven, not walking through heaven, flying over heaven, getting an overview. And I know, once again, as I mentioned before, that if he could come back today, he would be an example, has been an example, and would continue to be that example of one who walks with Jesus Christ, and would encourage you to do the same. and would lead you to him as his servant, and then let him take over from there. Let's pray. Father, we thank you again for this man that you placed on this earth at this time to serve you and to serve his country. We thank you that he's been diligent in that service of his country and diligent in his service of you, and his willingness to share that service with all of us. Lord, we ask that you would indeed pour out your spirit upon his family, that you would be their comfort, that you would be their strength, and that you would give direction in days to come, that they would continue to move forward as Dan would want them to, as you would want them to, Lord, until that time that you call each one of us to join you in the forever family reunion. Lord, put your hand upon his wife and his children. Lord, give them encouragement and strength to walk in your ways, Lord. We ask that you would direct their paths according to your Holy Spirit, Father. Lord, we desire that we would be able to honor you just as Dan has honored you with our lives. And at that time when we depart from this life, that we would bring honor to you also. Thank you, Lord, for your love and your grace. We ask all these things now in Jesus' most holy and precious name.
Friends, on behalf of Patsy and the kids, just want to thank you for your support. Please keep them in your thoughts and prayers as the days come along. Thank you for your help once again. This does conclude the service. Feel free to visit at this point.
Come on.